Good morning, everyone. Today, I'm going to make presentations on safety, health, and environmental management coursework under the assignment Workplace Hazard Analysis and Control. Let me quickly introduce myself. I'm Mr. Chow from Melaka Learning Center, that gained Master in Project Management. So the objective of this assignment is to bring awareness about work environmental hazard and hazard control methodology. The common standard approach towards workplace hazard management always fall under hazard identification, risk assessment, and risk control, or in short form, HIREC, as well as organization level, occupational safety, and health management system. So I have taken Dominant Outdoor Technologies, a semiconductor turnkey manufacturing hub, as a reference for my assignment, because in this manufacturing hub, it has various categories of hazard, ranging from chemical labs, compact office space, production floor, logistic areas, as well as fire hazards for wastewater treatment. So under OSHA 1994, first of all, we have to categorize the workplace hazard. So the workplace hazard has been identified into six categories. They are safety physical, environmental, chemical, economics, biological, and work organization stress. There are five possible factors under the categories of hazards. That is, people awareness, both employer and employees, equipment certifications and compliance, safety materials, MSDS leadership, environmental impact, and operational process control hazards. So knowing the sources as well as the category of hazard, now we need to prevent and control from impacting the employees. So we have five categories over here. For the topmost, eliminations of the source of hazard, to substitutions if elimination is not possible, engineering control, example by okay, administrative control through awareness. Also, if the above prevention control is not that possible, then employees are advised to guard on personal protective equipment, PPE. So in short, imagine if, let's say, we are working at a place where safety and health are not placed at the highest priority, which means that there is no hazard category, there is no prevention control. Would you feel confident working in this place? How does an employee have some good knowledge to tackle the safety and health issue? Certainly, if any hazard happens, it brings implications to the operational downtime, compensation loss, and damage to the branding. Hence, workplace hazard control and prevention is definitely critical for the good will of the working environment.